You're watching UNICEF television. A powerful display of beauty and unity as the world confronts one of history's largest health threats for both adults and children. With the familiar red ribbon looming, these dancers open the 16th International AIDS Conference. More than 24,000 experts and advocates, including more than 1,000 young people, are gathering here in Toronto for a week of brainstorming to halt the spread of HIV/AIDS. Bill Gates opened the conference with a message of hope, saying the world is doing more than ever, but it needs to do a better job to protect the most vulnerable.
Right now, one of the most widely practiced approaches to prevention is the ABC program for abstain, be faithful, use condoms. This approach has saved many lives, and we should expand it. But for many at the highest risk of infection, ABC has its limits. Abstinence is not often an option for poor women and girls who have no choice but to marry at an early age.
Earlier, UNICEF Deputy Executive Director Rima Sala opened the Unite for Children, Unite Against AIDS stand in the Global Village, the conference's networking area.
A whole generation of young people today has never known a world free of HIV and AIDS. It is a disease that has redefined childhood, forcing many of them to grow up alone, too fast, and in many cases, sadly, not at all.
She also made her mark by writing a message in support of the campaign. Later, others offered their thoughts on a board that will be delivered to the United Nations. UNICEF's team of experts has been here organizing and hosting a number of side events and meetings, including this one on gathering evidence to improve programs that help children affected by HIV/AIDS. The theme of this year's AIDS conference is Time to Deliver. UNICEF is here to make sure that children are included in the discussion. In Toronto, this is Thomas Nybo reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.